Hello, children! Welcome to our online good news club! So I know that some of you have already started your online school classes, so I hope you will do your best in studying so that you will get good grades for the glory of God. So this time, we will study the Word of God. So that's why we have prepared a new song to learn, a new verse to memorize, and a new story to tell. And we will also meet a new teacher. Are you excited to see her? But before that, I have a question to ask you. Who is your favorite superhero? Maybe some of you like Superman, or maybe Spider-Man, or maybe you like Wonder Woman. But did you know, children, that there is one true superhero in the Bible who really saved us by dying instead of us? Who is he? Do you want to know who is he? So we will meet him by the song that we have prepared today. So I know some of you have already learned this song, so please sing together with me. Ready?
I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. Jesus, my Lord. He walks with me and talks with me. Tells me that he loves me and will always with me be. I've got a wonderful Savior. Is he yours?
Okay, very good, children. Did you find out who is he? Who is our wonderful Savior? Yes, he is Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ is the Son of God who came down here on earth so that we can be saved and be forgiven from our sins. So this time, we will learn the lyrics of the song, and at the same time, we will also learn together the action. Are you ready? So it says here first, I've got a wonderful Savior. So the action will be, I've got a wonderful Savior. So you will bend a little. And then the second one, I've got a wonderful Savior. And then the last, I've got a wonderful Savior. Okay, so the meaning of that, I've got a wonderful Savior. So who is our wonderful Savior? I've told you earlier, right? Jesus Christ. So why is he wonderful? Because first, he's powerful, he's almighty, and he loves us. He loves us so much that he died on the cross for us. So it's also said there that he walks with me. So the action is so you will raise your hand, position like this. So he walks with me. So in your feet, so you will move a diamond step with your hand like this. So again, I will repeat, he walks with me and then talks. So you will jump, but not too high, like this. So he walks with me and talks with me. Okay, did you follow it? And then next step, and tells me that he loves me. So you will make your hand like this and tells me that he loves me and will always with me be. Okay, did you follow? So it says there that he walks with us. It means he's always together with us, whatever we do. And then he also talks with us. So we talk to him through our prayers. And how do Jesus talk to us? By the Bible. So when we read the Bible, it's like Jesus Christ talking to us. And then it says there that he tells us that He loves us, right? Tells me that He loves me and will always with me be. So because Jesus loves us so much, He will always be with us. He will protect us and He will guide us in everything that we do. So that's why He is our wonderful Savior. So to all the children who believe that Jesus is their wonderful Savior, so I would like you to join me in singing and dancing. So if you are sitting, I hope you will stand up so that we can sing and dance together. Are you ready?
I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. Jesus, my Lord.
He walks.
He walks with me and talks with me. Tells me that He loves me and will always be with me.
Jesus Christ is our wonderful Savior.
I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. Jesus, my Lord.
He walks.
He walks with me and talks with me. Tells me that He loves me and will always be with me. I've got a wonderful
great, you're so good in dancing and singing. This time we will sing the song and the second time we will dance only, okay? No more singing, so that we will be prepared to study our memory verse, okay? So let us all be happy and be joyful that Jesus is our wonderful Savior. Let's sing.
I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. Jesus, my Lord.
This time we will clap our hands.
He walks with me and talks with me. Tells me that He loves me and will always with me be. I've got a wonderful Savior. Is He yours?
How very good, children. So this time, make sure not to make any noise, okay? But dance carefully.
I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. I've got a wonderful Savior. Jesus, my Lord. He walks with me and talks with me. Tells me that He loves me and will always with me be.
Father God, we give You thanks and we give You glory for this another day and for this opportunity that we are going to learn a new Bible verse and new lesson. Help us to understand it and give us a joyful heart while studying Your word. We give You all the glory and praise in this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, children, I have something for you. But before that, I would like to ask you a question. Have you ever received any mail or letter? How did you feel about it? Were you happy? Probably yes, especially if it was a good news. Do you know, children, hearing a good news is very joyful. So now we have a good news. Wow!
Yay!
You want to hear it? Okay. So our today's good news, we will hear it from this book. Okay, probably some of you already know what is this. But what is this again? Right, Bible. It is not just an ordinary book, but it is special because it is the Word of God. It is written by God. It is the Word of God written by the apostles or inspired people through the Holy Spirit. And do you know, children, it is divided into two, the Old Testament and the New Testament. And it composes of 66 books. So many, right? Our today's good news, we will hear it or we will know it from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 3 and 4. It is in New Testament. So here, first I am going to read it, but then later we will read it together. Okay, so listen carefully and be attentive, okay? Okay, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 3 and 4. It says here that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. So it is very beautiful, right? And you know, children, our good news today is very important because it is the word of God, right? Okay, now we will read it again together. We have here written in here. Okay, are you ready? Ready, set, go! 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 3 and 4. Okay, we will read it on the board. But first, we will read from the address. So this is what you call the address. Then this is the content. So the address is 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 3 and 4. This is the book, 1 Corinthians. This is the chapter 15. And this is the verses 3 and 4. Okay, so we will read it by reading first the address, then followed by the content, then back to the address. Is that okay? Alright, are you ready? 1, 2, 3, go! 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 3 and 4. That Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. Wow, very good, children. You read it well. Okay, children, we're not just hearing it, but we need to memorize it. But before that, we will know first the meaning of this verse. So it says here in verse 3, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. Meaning, Christ died for everything that we thought, we said, or done that against God. For all our sins according to the scriptures. And next, in verse 4, it says here that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. Meaning, he was really buried and on the third day, he was risen from the grave. And it's all according to the scripture, meaning it is all true. Since we knew the meaning of this memory verse, I invite those children who do not know God yet, he wants you to accept him with all your heart and believe that he died for you. And for those children who already know God, he wants you to share this good news to other children who not yet hearing this good news. So now, for us to memorize it well, I prepared to you an action. So first, like this, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. We will do this. That Christ died for sins according to the scriptures. Then, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures, like this. He was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. So again, can you follow me? Okay, let's do this. 5, 6, 7, go. That Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. Okay, children. Now, for us to really memorize this verse, we will read it in a loud voice. The next, try that, no voice, only in your mind. Okay? Ready, set, go! 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 and 4. That Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he raised on the third day according to the scriptures. Very good, children. Now, only your mind can read this verse. Okay? Ready, set, go.
Children, where is Elijah the very last time Elisha saw him? Yes, very good. Elisha saw in his eyes that Elijah was caught up in heaven, and he was the second person God took away without dying. Elijah is a very faithful and a very nice prophet. He is faithful to God all his life. And you know, his ministry doesn't finish in that day only. After 900 years, many prophets, priests, and kings lived and died. And after that, God sent his promised child, and that is the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, where he is here on earth, he was here on earth, he met the 12 disciples, and he talked about a lot of story from God's word in the Old Testament. He talked about what will happen to him, his death, his resurrection, and all the good teachings that Jesus Christ, all the disciples know it through Jesus Christ. One day, after the meeting was finished, he took Peter, James, and John together with him in a very high mountain. After traveling in that high mountain, while traveling there, you can imagine how beautiful the sky was, how great is God's creation was. And you know, every time the three disciples went together with Jesus Christ, they are very amazed because Jesus Christ was a very passionate man. After that, children, Jesus Christ told his disciples, the three disciples, to wait in a remote place, and he will go more in the upper part of the mountain and he will pray. Jesus Christ sat down and he prayed. And just as he did every time, he prayed with a passionate heart. You know, while he was praying, the very amazing thing happened, took place in that time. The Bible says that Jesus Christ was transfigured. His whole body changed. His face shone like the sun. His clothes was white as snow. Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. When the disciples saw what had happened to Jesus, they began to realize that Jesus Christ is not only man, but he is the living God who created all things in this world. He created you and he created me also. He created everything that you see here in the world. And he created also the feelings that we have so that we can glorify him with our spiritual heart and mind. He wants us to have faith in him. He created also the faith you have. God wants us to be with Him everything, in everything we are doing. You know, that's why He get Peter, James, John, so that if their ministry, if they will have their ministry given by God, they will know that God is a true living God. God says in the Bible that He loves us so much. He loves us even though He is a God. He sacrificed Himself for us. And He wants us to be with Him someday eternally in His home, in heaven. God is truly an amazing God. His change was a very proof that He is a true God. Not only that, secondly, a very amazing thing took place in that time. Suddenly, two men appeared in Jesus Christ's side. Who do you think they are? The first man was Moses. Do you know anything about, do you know any special thing about Moses' life? Yes, very good. Moses was used by God to divide the Red Sea so that the people will go to the promised land. Not only that, secondly, God uses Moses to carry the two tablets, which are the Ten Commandments God wrote with His hand. You know, children, Moses was the law hander of God. Not only that, there is also the second man. Who is it? The 900 years before? The second main character in our story? Yes, very good. He is the prophet Elijah. Very good. They are both in the side of Jesus Christ. And when the disciple was saw them, they thought, we need to build a great tabernacle for the three person. But you know, God is not pleased with that kind of mind. That is sin. Sin is anything that we think, say, or do. Peter's mind was very, very arrogant, and he decided only what he wants, not what God wants. God doesn't please with that kind of attitude. You know, children, all of those sin, God wants it to punish through the fiery furnace, which is the hell. The eternal punishment is that you will be in hell and you will never see God because of your sin. But God doesn't want that. That's why He sacrificed Himself for you and for me, so that someday we will meet God in heaven and He will fulfill His promise, which is the eternal life. Children, God does not want you to think just what Peter think. That's why the prophet Elijah and Moses and Jesus Christ, what do you think they are talking about? They talk about the death of Jesus Christ. That in the third day, Jesus Christ will rise again. Just as our memory verse told us, that Jesus will not stay dead, but He will be alive again, so that we will be alive in Him and we will be with Him through all the days of our life. Jesus Christ wants us to be with Him forever and ever in His home in heaven. You know what? After what had Peter said, suddenly the two men disappeared and Jesus Christ was back into a normal person. And suddenly, a great big voice in heaven was heard. This is my Son, in whom I am well pleased. Listen to Him. Who do you think He is? He is the God the Father. He wants the disciples to know that Jesus Christ is not only the prophet Elijah, He is not Moses, He is not the kings in the Old Testament, but He is the true living God, higher than the prophet, priest, and king. He wants you to know that also, children. You must have a high thought about who Jesus Christ is. He is not only man, but He is a God who can see your heart, who can feel what you feel, who know what you are thinking right now. Now Jesus Christ came down where the three disciples have been staying, and the three disciples bow down together. They confess what they think. They confess that Jesus Christ is truly the God and the Savior of this world. So this time, children, God wants to challenge you. He wants you to know every step you take, everything you think, every move you make, that you need to glorify Him, because He wants you to have a deep relationship to Him. So this time we will pray. First, we will confess our sin. Secondly, we will thank God that He is a great Savior that we have, that He will save us from all our sins. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank You for the story of Elijah. Not only that You change us in our personality, but You change us within us so that we can know You better. We can put in our hearts that You are the only living God that we need to serve, that we need to glorify, and we need to praise. Bless the other activities that we will gonna do. And this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Just like the three disciples who bowed down and believed that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior, He also wants you to acknowledge Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So, to all children who want to believe in Jesus, let us dance this victory song together.